What's going on, sub stalkers and freaks, and welcome back to Dead Jester Circus. Well, news recently dropped that Jason Reitman, the son of Ivan Reitman, is actually going to be directing the brand new Ghostbusters movie. And you know, that piqued my interest because I feel if anybody's gonna do justice and pay respect to the original two movies, who better than the son of the director of the original two? So I hadn't done a Ghostbusters video in a long time, and I was gonna do a video talking about that probably this weekend or this coming week. And then this happened. Now, I couldn't help myself. I should have waited to do a reaction video to it, but I just went ahead and watched it anyway because I'm that much of an impatient child. But in case you were wondering what my reaction was to this trailer, it went a little something like this. And I have to say, this is very smart on Sony's part, and I can't believe I'm saying smart and Sony in the same sentence here, but it's very smart on their part that they released this just after announcing that Jason Reitman is going to be the director. Because releasing a trailer like this, the way that they did, it starts building up the positive hype, it starts building up the positive buzz, it starts washing away the bad taste of that 2016 movie out of people's mouths. It is now giving fans something to chew on, to look forward to for in 2 years, so that way there wasn't this cloud of mystery for the next 2 years over what's going on, what are they going to do. They came forward point blank with this trailer and said, fuck everything from that 2016 movie, we're going back to what you guys want, and we're going back to the originals. But one interesting thing with that trailer, and this might be just my fan brain kind of overreacting and going into overdrive here, and now any Ghostbusters fan would probably know what I'm talking about here, but in case you don't, there was a scene in the original movie where Peter forces Ray to take out 3 mortgages on his house.
My parents left me that house. I was born there.
You're not gonna lose the house. Everybody has 3 mortgages nowadays.
But at 19%, you didn't even bargain with the guy.
Ray, for your information, the interest rate alone for the first 5 years comes to $95,000.
Now I bring that up because could that be the family house property of Ray's stance? It might be a little too early. It could be just a metaphor about how Ghostbusters has been packed away for so long and now they're gonna blow the dust off of it. It's been dormant and they're going back to the old stuff. But it is fun kind of speculating that maybe that could be a Ray Stantz connection. Because if you remember, he's the one who bought the car in the original. He fixed it up. Him and Egon were like the two that really worked hand in hand with that sort of thing. So if anybody's gonna be taking home the proton packs and the gear and the car, it was probably Ray. But anyway, as always, like, comment, and subscribe. Adios, and GTFO.